Hello friends, welcome to DevMaster YouTube channel. I have started this channel to share my technical knowledge on software development. This is my first video, hope you will like it. So let's get started. Today we are going to learn how to integrate Firebase Crashlytics into an Android application. So let's get started. First of all, we will create a small Android application which will have a crash. So empty activity. Let's give name something Crashlytics demo. Kotlin is the language. API level 16. There are some issue with API level 15, so I have kept as 16 as minimum. Still, this covers 99.6% devices, so this looks all good. Click on finish. So now a new application will be created with simple text view. It will take some time to sync the project. Then now go to the layout of the activity. This preview is very small, so maximize it. So this will have a text view. I don't want that. Let's make this as button. Yes, give some ID. So crash now or crash button. Give text. Click to crash. Save it. Go to the activity. Get a reference of that button. Crash button dot set on click listener. Crash now. Add a new function for crash. Private function. To create outside this function, private func crash now. So for that we'll throw a runtime exception. Runtime exception with some message app crashed. Cool. Now run this application to see crash on button click. It will take some time to load into the emulator. So now go to the Firebase account. So yes, I'm into Firebase now. So there is no project. So to add Firebase Crashlytics, you have to add a project. So create a project. I think this is ready to run. It's this is installing now. It's launching. Click to crash. Oh, it crashed. Yes. So let's do one more time. Open app again. Yes, it crashed. So now we have to integrate the Firebase Crashlytics. Give a name to your project. I've given dev master. Continue. I don't want Google Analytics now, so just check this. Create project. Let's create a new project. Okay, your new project is ready. Click continue. Okay, so this is my console for that newly created project. I have to integrate now. So there are many options in Firebase, but I have to integrate only Crashlytics. So click on that. So you can choose Android because we are doing it for Android. So we have to register our application here. So it asking for Android package name. Package name you will get it from Gradle. This is my package name. Control C, copy this and paste it here. This is optional. App nickname is optional, so I'm not going to write it. This is also optional. Click on register app. The second step is download config file. So this config file has some configuration. We have to put this file into our app directory. Okay, so let's download it. Save file. Thing is downloaded here. I'm just doing copy. Let's paste into the app directory. Changing to project view app, just paste it there. Cool. So this part is done. Now click on next. So third step is add Firebase SDK. So we have to do some file change project level build.gradle. So we have to write Google memory repository, then this thing, and this. Let's see the current state of. Okay, let's change the project to Android. This is my project label. So Google, it's already there, no problem. So dependency, okay, we have to add this because there is no dependency. So just copy this line and paste it. And then we have to all repository, all project repository. I think it's all good. So just sync this thing. Rest all is okay. Yeah, all good. Now we have to add some lines in app level build.gradle. These two things. So app level, this thing. So first is apply plugin com Android application. I think this is already there, so no need to add it. Add this line. Cool, I'm adding this line. Now, okay. This add SDK for desired Firebase product. So we have to add our Crashlytics here. So press sync now. Okay, cool. Sync now. This done. Now go to next. Okay, so all these four steps are done now. I think there is no confusion in all these four steps. Click on console. There are some more settings we need to do in our application. So we are doing a setup a Firebase app. Click on next. go to Crashlytics documentation here. Okay, again we have to check all those files. So project label build.gradle we have to add. I think this add, I think we have already added, so let's do it again. These two things, okay. So let's remove, both are same. Sync now, and now we have to add one more because these two we have already added. So now you have to add this into our app level build.gradle. Cool. And SDK, these two are the dependency that we have to add into the dependency section. Cool. I think this is all required to integrate. So let's verify once again. This line and these two dependency and this Google service and this plugin. Cool. Sync now. And run the application because it's saying run your project step 4. Cool. And now I'm running the application. Is taking some time because we have added some new dependency, so Gradle will download all those dependency. So on button click, app is crashing and the crash will be reported in Crashlytics. So yeah, it's all done. I'm crashing again. I don't know, I have Wi-Fi available or not. Oh, 2-time crash. So let's see how to. Okay. So installation successful. This will automatically come once your successful sync is done and you run the application. Then this will automatically say installation successful. Go to Crashlytics dashboard now. Hope we'll see that those crashes. Yeah, so you can see one crash, one user affected, and the crash is on main activity. And if you click on the line, you will see the more detail about the crash. Main activity line number 19 on click and crash now. So you can all relate what is happening, what's wrong is happening in this crash. See the line number 19, crash now is a function, and this is click off some button on create method. So we can easily debug what lead this crash. Cool. So this is how we can integrate the Firebase Crashlytics into Android application. Hope you have liked this video. So in future I'll bring more videos. Please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.